Well, today we're going to be flying a high altitude balloon experiment that's been designed by the students at the Indiana School for the Blind and Visually Impaired. They've created some custom payloads. We'll be launching up into the fringes of space to coincide with today's eclipse event. We should be able to reach about 90,000 feet today, depending on atmospheric conditions, and we'll be then popping the balloon at 90,000 feet and re-entering back into the troposphere, which is the part of the atmosphere that we live in. This is a great opportunity to test out what happens to various experiments when they go up and are exposed to extreme temperatures, all the way to negative 60 degree Fahrenheit, UV light, and a lot of G-forces. Tactile Engineering makes the Cadence Braille tablet, which is a tactile pocket-sized computer for people with visual impairments. It has pins that move up and down that the user can feel with their hand, and then they can achieve access to information.
Okay.
So I was an astronaut with NASA from 1996 until 2012. I flew on three space shuttle missions that all supported construction of the International Space Station. The space station was pretty amazing. You know, it's still up on orbit today. It's had a continuous human presence since November of 2000. Every single day since then, there have been at least two astronauts living up there. So it's pretty tremendous. This event's really, really cool. I mean, you know, first off, I'm a Purdue grad, and Purdue is sponsoring this at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway. It's my first time at the Speedway. To see so many people that are really excited and interested in what is going to be an amazing scientific event, and perhaps go ahead and inspire a whole generation of kids into a science and technology, I think it's pretty neat. You know, I mean, for kids out there, I'm saying the world is an amazing place, and the eclipse that they're going to see is a part of that, and that somebody gets to go ahead and do these things and explore, and I hope that all of them feel that they certainly can have a chance, because we have so many people as examples as to what they can achieve if they go ahead and set their minds to it.
All right, so this engine sat in front of the Marshall Space Flight Center headquarters building for many years, and when the building got decommissioned, our group, which is a public affairs group for NASA Marshall, took possession of it and mounted on this trailer so that we could take it around and show it to the public. It has been fired. We think it was a test engine. During the shuttle era, they used to recycle the motors off the back of the shuttle. And so they would take them off and refurbish them and put them back on and fly them again. And to do the repairs that they needed, they probably used this as a test engine. You can see some of the repairs that they made on this one in particular, trying to verify all their methods and figure out how to, you know, turn the engines around. So we think that's what it was used for. Well, it was space shuttle originally. We're still using the RS-25 on our new Artemis rocket, the SLS rocket. We're putting four of them on there. We are actually building new ones, and they're slightly upgraded. I think they're producing a lot of, probably 20% more thrust than this one did. I don't know the numbers exactly. Somewhere in the order of 500,000 pounds of thrust each. And of course, you got the two SRBs, and they're running 3.5 million pounds of thrust per. So 8.8, something like that, million pounds of thrust for the whole vehicle.